The Queen had no idea crown jewels hidden in a biscuit tin to protect them from Hitler. The royal family hid the crown jewels in a biscuit tin during the World War II to protect them from Adolf Hitler in plans so secret Queen Elizabeth didn't even know, it has been revealed. The order, given by King George VI, was so secret that not even Queen Elizabeth II knew about it. The discovery was made by royal commentator Alastair Bruce. He said, "They dug out this fresh, very virgin white chalk and they had to hide it with tarpaulins so when the aircraft flew over at night no clue was given to the German Luftwaffe that anything was going on." Mr. Bruce added that both the Black Prince's ruby and St. Edward's sapphire were stored in a biscuit tin at Windsor Castle. "These are parts of the Imperial State Crown. The Imperial State Crown is an impressive crown in the royal collection, and the Queen wears it to state openings of Parliament. It has a lot of very old and valuable gems, including sapphires belonging to St. Edward the Confessor and Alexander II of Scotland, a ruby from Edward the Black Prince, pearls from Elizabeth I and the Cullinan II diamond." The royal commentator detailed an electric set of letters from Sir Owen Morshead, the royal librarian, to the mother of King George, Queen Mary. "The hole for the precious gems was dug beneath a sallyport and was accessible through a trapdoor on the grounds, which still exists." Mr. Bruce stated that telling the Queen of the move to keep the pieces of royal history from the clutches of the Nazis seemed strangely odd. He added, "What was so lovely was that the Queen had no knowledge of it. There had been in a book in our research that the Queen had been shown them during the war when they appeared at Windsor." The discovery was found as part of a BBC documentary dubbed The Coronation that will air on Sunday. The Queen was crowned in June 1953, and as most monarchs since the 13th century before her, she wore the St. Edward's crown on that day. The current incarnation of the crown is decorated with 444 precious and semi-precious stones, with Baroque arches. When not in use, it is on public display in the Jewel House at the Tower of London. 5 swords are also part of the royal collection, all are carried in the coronation procession. However, only the jewelled sword of offering is presented to the new monarch by the Archbishop of Canterbury. Scepters are another addition to the crown jewels that are recognizable from the many portraits of royalty throughout history. The scepter with the cross, known as the royal scepter, the sovereign's scepter, or the St. Edward's scepter, was made in 1661 for Charles II. It represents the crown's temporal authority. In 1905, the tip of it was redesigned to fit the Great Star of Africa, otherwise known as the Cullinan I diamond. A diamond.